Welcome back, everyone. This is a patron lesson for the classes and courses tier and above. We're going to look at bongos and how you can play some different grooves easily by using what we call pop style. So this is non-salsa style, non-traditional style, and it's pretty easy, and it's a style that I use a lot as a percussionist when I'm playing different gigs. You know, I don't do mostly Latin drumming gigs, right? I'm not like a salsa, I'm not in a salsa band. So when I play with different groups, I'm using, you know, what we call pop technique or, you know, general percussion technique, which the good news is it's pretty easy. It's not complicated. You don't have to do the hand fingers. We don't do the thumb fingers move like we do with the martillo. We don't really do that so much. We, generally speaking, are going to be using kind of just alternating one E and a two E and a three, you know, with some ghost notes. So that's what this lesson is going to be using. So the main thing in this, the point of this lesson is to show you how you can get some variations, different grooves, but using a really easy hand pattern or sticking pattern, you know, handing pattern, which is just alternating. And you guys know that I do a lot of alternating hand pattern rhythms because it fits into different grooves. It's low stress, it's easy, and it's musical and it sounds good. So let's do it. I've got a hi-hat here just to keep time. And that's another component of this lesson. I wanna invite all of you to get some sort of, it doesn't have to be a hi-hat, but something that you could make a sound with one of your legs. Provided you can move both your, you know, either of your legs or one of them, and have like a pedal. It could be a cowbell, it could be a cabasa pedal, a clave pedal, woodblock pedal, cowbell pedal, hi-hat, shikare pedal. There's all kinds of different pedals that you can use just to give yourself a beat. And also, not only for practice, so you're keeping the beat, that's one aspect of it, but also because if you get invited to do a gig or you want to jam with friends, you may have, you might want to use another instrument that gives you just like two, you're doing the job of two people basically. So it would be like keeping the time, just like a shake-a-de player or cowbell player. And you can do that, of course, with your, one of your feet. So we've got that, and that's a good thing to practice. It also just helps with general coordination, like any drummer. Drum set player or percussionist, multi-percussionist, where we're using a, you know, hybrid setup. And eventually I'm going to be doing more in this series for you all that include more instruments. And so this is the beginning of that. So it's a nice introduction to that hybrid setup idea. All right, so let's get back to the bongos. What are we doing? We're doing alternating hands. So the first thing you want to get used to is just right, left, right, left, right, left, and do that with a beat. One, two, let's play. So you could try a pattern like this, dot, get dot, get dot, and start doing accents. And throw in a hit on the low drum. Easy, same hand pattern. All this is the same. So we're never stopping. All right, so that's a little bit like the marcha pattern. But we're not doing, right, we're just doing. So a little bit easier, and I like it. I like it. It's just got a lightness to it. It sounds good in a mix, you know, guitar, bass, maybe a drummer playing some light stuff with brushes or bundled sticks, you know, and that's gonna sound great. All right, so let's look at some variations. I'm just gonna mix it up a little bit, and this is what I want you to do when you practice. Almost like a wawanko, right? Two, three, four. this and sing clave. So that's one variation, one kind of variation space. So you can think of these as different types of grooves. Like the first one we did, that's almost like calypso rhythm-ish, just very straight ahead. This one, a little more syncopated, a little more wawanko zone, all right? We're not trying to recreate traditional rhythms here. What we're trying to do is draw upon these different genres and integrate them into our own playing. And so when you do this, you know, we're not trying to recreate specific patterns like, you know, we're learning a style. We're trying to be musical and draw from styles and be our own musician, you know, because you're the boss of what you play, right? It's just good to know where these things come from. But, you know, when you're on a gig, you're making the choices. That's your music. So just, you know, do whatever you think is the most musical thing. Let's look at a little more syncopated stuff. I know some of you are more advanced players, so if you're a beginner, don't worry. You've got, you know, plenty of time to work your way up to doing more syncopation, but I want to do something for our intermediate slash advanced drummers. So here we go. A one, two, one, two. Okay, just some ideas, some inspiration. So that's what I'd like you to do, is practice. You can get a hi-hat, you can get a cowbell, any kind of pedal. Or, if you don't want to get a pedal, get some ankle bells or ankle pods. You know, there's lots of great rattle sounds out there, and you can just use your foot. I even have a music therapist, percussionist friend of mine. He sticks a maraca under his shoelaces and just taps his foot. And has a maraca. There's also my wife's a music therapist, and when she does some sessions, they have a little tambourine, a foot tambourine. They're wonderful and they're inexpensive. Just a little, it's kind of like a little scallop shaped, like a kidney bean shaped tambourine. It goes on the top of your foot, little strap around the bottom, and you're good to go. You can have like a little jingle sound. Lots of options, you guys. So get something going. So you can tap your foot, keep a beat, and then play along to it, all right? So it's a good practice for you, and like I said, you can emulate the role of another percussionist or timekeeper. I think it'll also help you stay in time, and if you're doing a solo while you're keeping time, you know, it helps everyone else know where you are and where the beat is. So there's lots of reasons you want to have a steady beat going, and maybe in the future, it doesn't have to be a steady beat, it can be another rhythm, right? Like a lot of players play clave or some other rhythm in their foot as well. So you can take it to different levels, but for now, start off with a steady beat, add in a drum. It could be any drum too. This is bongos, but it could be any hand drum, cajon, congas, djembe, whatever you want, all right? I hope this is helpful. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks for being a Courses in Classes patron, and I'll see you all in a future video.